Let us go to the book of Isaiah, chapter number 51. Isaiah 51. Verse number 1. Isaiah 51, verse number 1. Are we there?
Mwahageze.
The Bible says, hearken to me, you that follow after righteousness.
Ye
that seek the Lord.
Yemwe abarondera Uhoraho.
Look unto the rock where you are hewn.
Nitegereze igitandara mwasatuweko.
And to the hole of the pit where you have been dug.
Ninganzo mwimbwemwo.
Look unto Abraham your father and unto Sarah that bare you. For I called him alone and blessed him and increased him. Hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. I am here to speak about a carrier of the ancient mantles.
Ndagiye kuvuga ibijanye no gutwara umutamana wa kera.
How to become a carrier.
Gutushobora kuba igitwazi.
A vehicle.
Imodoka.
That carries the ancient mantles.
Itwaye umutamana wo mu bihe bya kera.
Praise the name of Jesus.
Imana ishimwe cyane.
On Friday, for those that were here, we speak about how a man can be empowered to serve God. And we spoke about how a man can be able to build up himself to be a man of impact in his generation. But this morning I want to be able to shift a little bit so that we can be able to talk about the ancient mantle. And I want to begin by saying this, that the word of God is a blueprint. It is like a reference point or a place where you can refer to. The Bible in itself is carrying references of how men walked with God. When you read the Bible, you are able to see a walk of a man with a God that is invisible. Men were able to receive the word of God and they began to trust a voice of an invisible God. And before this invisible God manifested to them, they received the word of God and they began to walk in it. And so this morning I want to help you to understand what made this man to be able to be turned into other men, that by reason of what they carried we can be able to apply in our own lives, in our walk with God. Praise the name of Jesus. And so it is important for us to understand that man is playing a very critical role in the agenda of God. There is no way the agenda of God can be fulfilled here on earth without the instrumentality of a man. Praise God. And so it is very important for us to understand who is a man. Praise God.
Amen.
Man has a place where he originated from. There is a place where a man began from. For instance, when you look at the story of
Adam,
when you go to the book of Genesis chapter
1,
you will see how God says in the book of Genesis chapter
1
verse 26,
that
let us make man in our own image. And in chapter 2 verse 7, he makes us to understand how he formed a man. The Bible says he was able to breathe into a man, and a man became a living soul. That means that man began his originality in God. What made a man to begin to walk? Made a man to become a living soul. It is the breath that God was able to breathe into him
that
made a man to become a living soul. That means the originality of a man is in the breath of God. And so the word of God is the genesis of a man, because the word is the breath of God. So when we are speaking about the origin of a man, it means the word of God is the origin of a man.
Nido rufatiro, nido nango yumono.
Hey, praise God.
Amen.
The origin of a man is the word.
Umuntu yavuye mu mana.
That's why Paul says in the book of 2 Corinthians chapter number 3 verse
1
and
2
and
3
that you are the epistle. That you are a pistol written in our hearts that is being read by men. That means a man is the word that has been written. Praise the name of Jesus. For you to understand a man, you must look at the origin. The origin is the breath of God released into a man. That means in and inside of a man, there is the word of God. That's why Paul comes and says in the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 3 that you are an epistle. That means that you are a word that has been written. Men are words.
Abantu ni jambo y'Imana.
Hey, praise God.
Imana ishimwe.
Men are epistle.
Abantu ni vyete.
That's why when God is now telling us in Isaiah 51,
Bibiliya ikatubwira muri Isaiah 51,
that look unto Abraham. Look unto
Sarah.
Look where I have dug you from. He is making you to refer back to be able to see the origin of where we came from. Because the man Abraham is a man of faith. That means that he was able to hear the word of God, and he was able to understand that word. Because the Bible says the faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. So that means that Abraham was able to receive the word, and he was able to believe in the word that he received. So when God is referring you to it, in other words, he's telling you, refer to the word that Abraham believed. Praise God. Are we together? So man is an epistle. The Bible says in the book of 2 Peter chapter number
1,
for the prophecy not came in all times by the will of man. Second Peter chapter 1. We can read there. Second Peter. Glory to God. Chapter 1. Verse number
21.
The Bible says, for the prophecy came not in all times by the will of a man, but holy men of God, they spoke as were moved by the Holy Ghost. Ah, praise the Lord. That means that men received the word and they began to speak the word of God as were led by the Spirit of God. That means that there is something that happens to a man when he comes in contact with the word, when he comes in contact with the Spirit of God. The Bible says that holy men
they did not just release a prophecy, but they received the word of God and they began to speak it as they were led by the Spirit of God. Man can never be separated from the word. The reason why you came early this morning is because you are going back to your origin. Something has pushed you to come back to your origin, which is the word of God. There is a hunger that a man receives. There is the anticipation a man must have. The anticipation to release, to give himself to the word. Because the origin of a man is the word. When man was able to be breathed upon by God, his existence depends on the word of God. Are we together? Are we understanding this? So when God is saying, look unto Abraham, he's actually telling you, look into the scriptures. That is your origin. Praise the name of Jesus. The scriptures is about man who moved from being man and they became spirits. Hallelujah. The scriptures, when you read the word of God, it is speaking about man that turned themselves, they were able to receive the word of God and they were able to be turned. Praise God. That's why the Bible says, has he not called him gods? And to whom the word of God came to. So when a man receives the word, he becomes a god. When a man receives the word, he becomes a god. The Bible says, has he not called them gods? And to whom the word of God came to. Praise God. So the scriptures or the Bible is full of men that became spirits by reason of the word of God. Are we together? Are you understanding this? Praise God. The Bible says in the book of John, chapter number 1, we can be able to read there. John chapter number 1,
Johann,
verse number 4. Apostle, we can read there. John chapter number 1.
Yohana gice cya mbere ku murongo wa kane,
verse number 14.
14, eh?
Yes.
Ku murongo wa 14.
What does it say, apostle?
Haravuga gute kandi uwo jambo yihaye umubiri abana natwe twitegereza ubwiza bwiwe n'ubwiza bw'umeze nk'umwana w'ikinege ava kwa se yuzuye ubuntu n'ukuri.
Hallelujah.
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 Praise God.
Imana ishimwe.
It says,
haravuze ngo,
it says this, and the word was made flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory, the glory as only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. So the word has the ability to become flesh. The word of God has the ability to be transformed into a flesh.
Hey.
Praise God.
Iman shimwe.
So when men received the word of God, they began to be transformed. Why? Because the word of God has the ability to dwell into a man. The word of God can become flesh. The word of God has the ability to fit into a flesh.
Hey.
Are you understanding? Praise God. Man has the ability to receive because the word has been made flesh. Praise God.
Amen.
Men who receive the word,
They were transformed. They were turned into another man. The Bible makes a reference of a man called Saul. When the time for him to be made the king came, the Bible says that Samuel met him when he was still looking for the donkeys. And the Bible says that Samuel told him that thou shalt be able to meet a company of prophets, and the Spirit of God shall come upon you, and thou shalt be turned into another man. When a man receives the Spirit of God, you are able to be turned into another man. You are changed in your formatting of a man. You change the basis of your man. You are no longer operating as a normal man, because you are carrying the Word of God in your inside. Praise God. Oh God. Men are changed. Men are changed into another man. There is a place where Elisha comes and looks at Elijah. When Elijah was just about to ascend and to release the mantle to him, when Elisha was looking at Elijah as he goes, there is a name that Elisha gave to Elijah. He said, the chariot of Israel and the horsemen thereon. So when Elisha was looking at Elijah, the man had been changed from just a man. He had become a chariot of Israel. He had been transformed into a chariot. He had become even the horsemen upon it. When you receive the Word of God, you are changed. You are empowered. The nature of you is changed when you receive the Word. Praise God. What do you see in the Word? When you read the scriptures, what are you seeing? What can you be able to see in the scriptures? What are your eyes seeing every time you open the scriptures? What are you seeing? Because what you can see in the scriptures is what you can become. Men that receive the Word of God, they did not remain the same. Why have you been in church for all these years and you cannot be changed into that world? Why are we seeing a disconnect of men every day who are always receiving the Word of God but have not become that word? They have not been changed into that word. Today, you must begin to become that one. I say today, you must begin to become that one. That when men will look at you, you will become the one. They will see the Word of God. They will see the Word of God. Praise God. Are we together? What are you seeing? The Word of God is able to change a man. I want to say this. When the Spirit of God cometh upon a man, it changes that man into another being. You can be able to refer to the book of 1 Samuel chapter number 10, verse number 6 to 7. First Samuel chapter number 10, 6 to 7. You can also look at 1 Samuel chapter 28, verse number 13. Praise God. When God releases the Word, He expects you to receive that Word and let the basis of what makes you to be a man to be changed. There is something so much powerful that that Paul says in the book of Acts chapter number 20.
Ariki ni Paul avuga mu gitabo cy'Ibyakozwe muri cha mirongo.
We can read there.
Turashaka kwasoma.
Acts chapter number 20.
Ibyakozwe muri mirongo 2.
Glory to God.
Imani shimwe.
Verse number 32.
Turashaka ku mirongo 32. Kandi none baragize Imani ijambo ry'ubuntu bwayo risobora kubaka no kubahera ibiragwa hamwe nabejejwe bose.
It says, I commend you to God.
Avuze ngo ndabaragije Imana.
And to the word of his grace.
N'ijambo ry'ubuntu bwayo.
Which is able to build you.
Rishobora kubaka.
And to give you an inheritance.
Ikabaha ibyasezeranye.
So the word of God.
Ijambo ry'Imana.
Has the ability to build a man.
Rifise ubushobozi bwo kubaka umuntu.
It has the ability to raise a man.
Rifise ubushobozi bwo guhagurutsa
umuntu. He says, I commend you to God.
Avuze ngo ndabaragije Imana.
And to the word of his grace that is able to build you. The word of God has the ability to build a man. But when you're reading that verse 32, you must go back to verse number 20. You can go back there. Read with me Acts chapter number 20, verse 20. What does he say?
Kandi munazi ko atajambo ribereye nacishije iruhande kubabarira cyane kubigishiriza imbere y'abantu mu nzu no mu yindi.
Hallelujah. He says this.
Havuga ngo
I have kept nothing from you.
Kandi murazi ko atajambo ribereye.
I have showed you.
Nacishije iruhande
kwabwiye.
Narababwiye byose.
What are you seeing in the scriptures?
Niki kimuri ko murabona mu ijambo
ry'Imana? Your eyes must see. Your eyes must see. What are you seeing in the scripture? He says, I have not hidden anything from you. But I have been able to show you. And I have taught you. That means when you come in contact with the world, you are not just about to be taught, but you are about to be shown. Praise God.
Imani shimwe.
What are you seeing?
Ni giki uriko urabona?
Isaiah 34.
Yesaya mirongo itatu
na kane. I'm trying to build up a case for you.
Ndiko ndubaka ikintu
for you to understand.
Kugira wewe utaure.
For you to come to the knowledge of the truth.
Kugira ngo uze gushika kumenya.
Isaiah 34 verse 16.
Turasoma Yesaya mirongo itatu na kane.
Aha.
Verse 6.
Verse 16.
16. Kumurongo wa 16. Yesaya mirongo itatu na kane 16. Ijambo ry'Imana riravuga ngo nimurondere mu gitabo cy'Uhoraho musome nta na kimwe cyo muri byo kizobura na kigore kizobura ikigabo cyacu kuko akanwa kiwe ariko kabigeze kandi impemu ziwe akaba arizo zibikoranije.
Haleluya. It says
haravuze ngo
seek ye out of the book of the law
nimurabe mu byanditswe
and read. None of these things
shall
fail. And then he says, I have released the word, but my spirit shall gather it together. I said, he says, I will release the word, but my spirit shall gather together. So he is making you to go back to the word. He says, seek ye for my word. And don't just seek it. But read that word. Because every word I have released shall never fail. The word of God shall never fail. It can never fail to a generation that has accepted the word. CLG. CLG. Have you received the word? He says the spirit shall gather the word. He shall be able to build up the
word
that received the word. The spirit of God is able to change. It is able to build up a man.
In
the spirit of God gathered the word of God in a man. Praise God.
Imani shimwe.
The Spirit gathers what God has spoken. So seek out for the word. Now when you go into the scriptures, there is something that is hidden, which I'm going to speak even in the next service. Praise God. That there is something hidden in the scriptures, which this generation, whether in Kenya, in Burundi, in Rwanda, has been able to forget. And that is the word mantle. I was just trying to build up a case for you to understand what it means for a man to receive the word. What it means for a man to be able to build, to be built with the word of God. There is a mantle. The word mantle that has been hidden in the scriptures, which this generation has forgotten about. But I want to bless the Lord, because when I was preparing for this session, the Spirit of God reminded me that it is time for this generation to go back to be reminded about the ancient mantles that men carried. Mantles that men carried. Mantles that the men of old in the Bible carried, which this generation has forgotten about. But I want to bless the Lord, because the Lord is restoring the ancient mantles into his church this morning. In the name of Jesus Christ. So let us go to understand what is a mantle. Because many times we have thought the mantle is just a face wiper. I don't know about here, but in Kenya, this thing is called a mantle. So it is held in very, very important, with a lot of importance. When you carry this, a man of God, not him carrying, but when you carry this for a man of God, Jesus Christ, you have carried something heavy. Because it carries the anointing of a man. But that is an error. The mantle is not a face wiper. It is more than a face wiper. Now let us go into the scriptures to understand what is a mantle. 1 Kings chapter number 19. 1 Kings chapter number 19. Is somebody being blessed?
Amen.
First Kings chapter number 19. Elisha is about to meet with Elijah.
Elisha.
Elijah was running away from Ahab and Jezebel. Then he goes somewhere and he hides himself. But while he was there, the Spirit of God reminds him, it is time for you to go back. And you are going to anoint three people. You are going to anoint Hazael. You are going to anoint Jehu. And you are going to anoint Elisha. When he meets Elisha, the Bible says this. Verse number 19.
Kumurongo wa 19. Haravuga ngo. Nuko avayo aragenda abona Elisa mwene Shafati ariko arimisha inka mirongo ibiri na zine zirongoye imbere yiwe zisangiye ingogo ari zibiri zibiri nawe ari kuzimperera Eliya akebereza iyari amutera ko umutamana wiwe.
Praise God.
Imana ishimwe.
He says he found this man plowing. He finds Elijah plowing. And the Bible says Elijah passed by him. And he casted his mantle upon him. Now, let us go back to verse number 13. What does it say, verse 13?
Haravuga ngo maze Eliya akumvise yifuka umutamana wiwe mu maso arasohoka ahagarara ku muryango w'iryo senga haza ijwi rimaze riti ukora iki hano ga Eliya arishura ati nagize ishaka ryinshi ryawe uhoraho mpamye n'ingabo kuko abisirayeli bavuye mu isezerano ryawe bagahumvagura ibicaniro byawe kandi bisize inkota abavugishwa nawe nije jenyine sigaye na jenyine barangenza ngo banyice.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
There are two instances of the mantle. Elijah has been able to receive the word. God has manifested to him. But when God manifests to him, the Bible says that Elijah wrapped his face with a mantle. He covered his face with a mantle. But when he is meeting Elisha, the Bible says that Elijah passed by and he casted upon Elisha a mantle. A mantle that he used to wipe his face has been able to push Elisha, because immediately the mantle was casted upon him, Elisha was able to turn away from the things he was doing. And he began to follow the man of God. That means that whatever was casted upon him was more than just a cloth. There is a supernatural power that came upon Elisha when the mantle was casted upon him. Look at these two instances. Elijah has wiped his face. He has covered his face with a mantle. But the same mantle that he casted upon himself catapults a man. It is able to remove a man from where he was. It changes a man that was plowing to begin to become a prophet. A mantle was able to be casted upon him, but it was able to usher a man called Elisha from being a plower of the land to become a prophet. There is something about the mantle that Elijah casted upon Elisha. That was not normal. Hey, praise God. Amen. So a mantle it was just a piece of garment. But it was turned into a weapon of the Spirit of God. Because it was able to remove this man called Elijah. Look at verse number
20. Asiga inka ngaho agenda ariruka akurikira Eliya aramubwira ati ndakwinginze reka mbaze mbanze nje gusezera data na mama meze nje gukurikire nawe ati genda ubonye nkugizene.
A man that was plowing, the Bible says immediately he received the mantle, he left everything that he was doing and began to run after a man. A man he had no idea who he was. A man he had never met. But by reason of the anointing that was upon the mantle, he ceased from being a plower of a land and began to run after a man. So what is a mantle? It means a change from being a garment It changed from being a garment. It became a carrier of the power of God. Hey, praise God. What is a mantle? 1 Samuel chapter 15.
Samuel,
we are reading for us to understand. Please don't get tired. 1 Samuel chapter number 15. We are reading to understand. He has told us that to receive my word and read. Isaiah 34:16. He has said, receive my word and read it. So when you receive the word, you must read it.
1
Samuel chapter 15. We are understanding what is a mantle. So we have seen it was a garment, but it became a puller. It became a
bulldozer
because it was able to pull a man from plowing a land into following a prophet. 1 Samuel chapter 15. Glory to God.
Which verse?
Let us look at verse number
26. Samweli yishura Sauli ateka sisubirayo sisubira nayo nawe kuko wansi jambo ryuhoraho nawe yanse kuba umwami wa Isirayeli.
Aha, verse 27
minongo birindwi nuko Samweli agihindukira ngo agende, Sauli ashingira umutwe w'impuzu yiwe iratabuka.
Praise God. We are seeing a story of Saul,
tuko tubona inkuru ya Sauli,
and that of the man of God Samuel. Samuel released a word to Saul. Because Saul was just about to enter into a battle. And the Bible says that Saul was supposed to kill the Amalekites, and he was supposed to destroy everything that he was to find there. But Saul goes ahead and fights the Amalekites, but he saves the king of the Amalekites, and he was able to take some things from there. So this thing has displeased God. And when Samuel comes and meets with him, the Bible says that Samuel asked him, what is this that I'm hearing? What is this that I can hear about the sheep? What is this that I can hear about the oxen? And Saul tells him, it is the sound of the sheep that we took from the Amalekites. And then Samuel tells him, why have you done this thing against the Lord? Immediately he releases the judgment that the way you have done, the kingdom of God has been removed from you, and that God has rejected you from being a king. Now when you now read that verse 27, the reaction of Saul helps us to understand what is a mantle. Because the Bible says when Saul was turning to go, Saul grabbed his garment.
Repeat once again.
When Samuel was turning to go, Saul
grabbed
his garment. Actually, the Bible says he grabbed his mantle. And the Bible says the garments of the man of God were torn in between. Read the next verse.
Samuel aramubwira ati, Uhoraho nawe uyu munsi agutabuye ko ingoma ya Abisirayeli ayihaye mugenzi wawe akuruta.
Hallelujah. So he says,
acharamubwira,
because you have done this,
kubera ukoze ibi,
the garment has been torn.
Kubera kunaburiye umutamana,
that means the kingdom has been torn in between.
Uku niko ubwami bwawe,
a garment of a man,
umutamana w'umuntu.
was representing the kingdom.
Wasobanura ubwami bw'umuntu.
Because when the kingdom was torn apart,
igihe ubwami bw'Imana
the sign of it was the garment of Samuel.
Nikubangomani bashamwe wari wa mutamana.
When Saul grabbed his garments,
igihe Sawuli afashe
they were torn in between.
Ugatabuka.
It means the kingdom of God had been torn.
Nikuvuga ngo ubwami bw'Imana bwari butabuze.
Are we understanding? So a garment of my man was not just a garment. It represented a kingdom. So when Saul grabbed the garment and the garment was torn between, a kingdom was being divided. Praise God. We are understanding what is a mantle. So a mantle represents a kingdom. When you look at what is a mantle, the mantle was representing the power of God to Elisha. But to Saul, the mantle was representing the kingdom. Because the kingdom had been torn apart. When he held the garment of the man of God, we are building to understand what is
going on.
Hallelujah. A mantle is not just anything. Now, let's go to 1 Samuel 28 to understand what is a mantle again. Then we are going to close from there and then we will go to the next verse, the next session. 1 Samuel 28. Let us look at the verse number 7. We will be able to read a little bit. 1 Samuel 28, verse
7.
Downwards.
Umufumukazi azi guhamagara imizimu nje kumubaza abantu be baramwijura bati hariho umufumukazi abizi iendori nuko Sawuli ariyoberanya nyambara izindi mpuzu ajana n'abantu babiri baje kuri umufumukazi mu ijoro maze Sawuli aramubarira ati ntabara umpamagarize umuzimu ubumenyi bwawe unzurire uwo ngira nkubarire uwo mupfumukazi aramwishura ati mbega ntuzi ibyo Sawuli yakoze ingene yahoneje abahamagara imizimu nabakamenye mu gihugu niki gitumye ugomba kuna mutego kugira ngo unyicishe Sawuli aramurahira ati uhoraho ati nkurahiye uhoraho hakagira ico uzoba kubyibi umupfumukazi aramuza ati ugomba nkuzurire nde nawe ati nzurira Samweli umupfumukazi abonye Samweli atura ubuku n'ijwi rirenga abaza Sawuli ati umbeshe yiki erega ni wewe Sawuli umwami aramushura ati humura mbarira ico ubonye nyamfumukazi aramushura ati mbonye igisa n'Imana kiduga kiva ikuzimu Sawuli aramaze ati gisa gite nawe ati hari kwaduga umutama kandi yambaye igikwemu maze Sawuli acamenya ko ari Samweli akubita inkoro hasi aramwunamira.
That is verse 14. Oh, okay. Praise God. So from this you understand that there is a time when Saul had been rejected by God. And he has tried to pray. God is no longer answering him. But the Bible says, at that particular time, Saul had made a decree that in this land, there shall be no diviners.
Na aha hariho ikintu Sawuli yari yarakoze yuko hatidosubira kuba ama divinity abantu bakora ibijanye n'ibintu nyene by'ubufumu canke ibintu nyene by'amareba.
Aha. And so the Bible says,
Bibiri avuga ngo,
that the battle was there for Saul to battle.
Hariho kandi urugamba rwari rurindiye
Sawuli. The Philistines had come to attack.
Aba Filistia bari baje.
And he needed to know whether he was going to win.
Rero yarakeneye kumenya ninde azotsinda.
And the Bible says,
Bibiri avuga ngo,
that he disgusted himself.
Hanyuma wenye n'ubwiwe
he changed himself into being able to go and visit a diviner.
Atavuga ati reka ngende ndondere umukamenyi.
And the Bible says there was a woman that was a diviner in that
region.
And so when he came to that woman, the Bible says that he went and asked the woman, can I be able to see a man? Can you be able to bring a man for me to see? And the Bible says the woman caused a Samuel to emerge. And when he emerged, Samuel asked the lady, who was the diviner, what are you seeing?
No. Sauli abaza uwo mpfumukazi aturi kubona iki?
And the Bible says, the woman told him, I see an old man. I see an old man. And he asked him, what form is he? He says, this man is having a mantle upon himself. So that means that even the man of old, even by passing on when they died, their mantle was still speaking. Their mantle was still alive. Even in death, the mantle of Samuel could still be seen. Praise God. The mantle of Samuel. He had died. But he was still being seen. I now understand that when the children of Israel one day were running away from their battle, the Bible says that they came and they were carrying a dead man. And when they saw the battle, when they saw the army of the attackers, they casted the dead man into the bones of Elijah. And the man came back to life. The man immediately revived. Why? Because the mantles of men are still alive even today. Praise God. Samuel and the mantle upon him could still be able to manifest even in death. He was still being seen. Elijah and his mantle was still speaking even in his death. The ancient mantles, the mantles of men that carried God, the mantles of men that walked with God, there is something that was supernatural that these men came in contact with when they were walking with men, when they were walking with God. And so you must come and understand it. Praise God. The Bible says in the book of Hebrews chapter number 12 that you have come to Mount Zion, to the city of the Lord. Then it says this, to the spirits of just men that have been made perfect. Let us read there.
No, it's okay.
Oh, okay. Yes. So he says this, when you come into the house of God, you are coming to spirits of just men that has been made perfect. I proclaim to you, somebody today, may you receive the mantle that the Lord is releasing upon you today. In the mighty name of Jesus, the power that Elijah walked in, it is still alive today. The power that men of God walked in, it is still alive today. Samuel manifested when Saul was requesting for him to be manifested. The mantle of Samuel awakened. The church needs that mantle. Praise God. So we are going to continue in the next as we build up that case. But it was important for you to understand what is a mantle. We have said the mantle represents the kingdom of God. The mantle represents the power of God. But the mantle itself is still alive. Even now it is still alive. That's why men are still being raised prophets. That's why men are still receiving the word of God. God can never do anything without the instrumentality of a man. That is why when God wanted to come into flesh, he looked for a body. He looked for a body because the man carries the God that is able to meet. When you meet God, you must carry him. Hallelujah. I want us to rise up. I want us to rise up in Jesus. The ancient mantles are available. The ancient mantles are available. You must only cry out to the Spirit of God. That God, whatever worked in Elijah, let it work in me. The mantle of David, that he could sing songs and transform nations, let that mantle be upon me. Whatever made Elijah to become Elijah, let that Spirit come upon me now. Begin to make that prayer. Begin to make that prayer. Begin to make that prayer in the name of Jesus. Begin to make that prayer in the name of Jesus Christ.
Father God, we thank you for this wonderful morning. We thank you for your word that is building us to understand the ancient mantles so that we could change our society. We thank you, Lord, for the supernatural power that you are releasing upon each one and everyone in this place to carry your presence, to carry your power, to shake the nations like never before. In Jesus' mighty name, let our life be transformed. Let our life be manifested. Let our life be changed so that we could be able to carry your presence and your glory. In Jesus' mighty name, amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.